Just a Muslim American sister in Niqab, sharing her life's ups and downs with everyday trials and faith in Allah, and well, just living the Niqabi life.
What is with you always messing with cords? Yeah, I'm talking to you. Don't walk away from me when I'm talking to you. You mess with that cord, you're going to be missing a paw, young lady. What do you have to say for yourself? Hey! What do you have to say for yourself? That's what I thought.
Assalamu alaikum. And good morning, everybody. Inshallah, everybody is doing well. Today is Thursday, and I have arrived at Safeway. There, Safeway. Why? Because I want to get myself a frappuccino. It is a frappuccino kind of morning because today I'm going to be assembling some dolls using the pieces I've already completed. So I'm actually quite excited. I was going to record. Well, no, actually, no, I wasn't. It's pretty clear this morning. Sort of clear. There's some clouds. It's gonna rain today, inshallah. I really want to watch the sunrise, but not today. Not this morning. I'm gonna get myself a frappuccino in a new cup. If you guys remember in the last vlog, my daughter put my frappuccino cup, the cup that I use for my frappuccinos or cold drinks, on the bottom of the dishwasher, and it kind of melted. So I need to get a replacement cup and get myself a frappuccino. I think I may pick up a bag of oranges because the bag of oranges I have in the refrigerator doesn't look too appetizing. So guys, I'm gonna try something new this morning. I'm gonna try the green matcha green tea frappuccino. I'm all for trying new things. New drink, something new. I was gonna get myself a caramel frappuccino, but I've been seeing the green matcha tea frappuccino for a while, so I wanted to give that a try. And after I pick this up, I want to pick up a bag of oranges. Inshallah. Guys, I did it again. I thought I was talking to you. I didn't push record. Anyways, I got myself the matcha, green matcha frappuccino. It's very interesting. It's good. Alhamdulillah. And then I came up to the flowers where I found my Gerber daisies. I love these so much. I love them in all colors. Look, they're beautiful. I love them. They're $5.99 each. I don't remember them costing that much before, but I'm definitely letting my son know that, hey, son, there are Gerber daisies at Safeway now. So go get me some Gerber daisies, please, if you love me. All right, so let me see. I need to pick up a bag of oranges. Because like I mentioned before, the oranges that I have at home, I think I waited too long. Because they're starting to turn a little bit white on the inside. It's no good. So pick that up and go home. Just look at that. Gorgeous. Gorgeous. Yeah, all the other flowers are fine. I mean, all the other flowers are beautiful and everything. I just prefer Gerbers. They remind me of me. Simple. I'm not gonna say beautiful. I'm just gonna say simple. Very beautiful morning though. Even though I did not go and watch the sunrise, it's still very lovely out here. I've got trees in the way. Why does everything have to be in the way, including this trade? Oh, it's so beautiful though. Guys, seriously, when you go out, look up and appreciate. Look up and appreciate. Why, good morning, Mr. or Miss Snail. How are you? You need to move out of the way before you get crushed. Assalamu alaikum, Snail. You just keep going on your little way. We'll see you. Hopefully not squished. Inshallah ta'ala. I'm home, guys. This cat, subhanAllah. Come here. Say assalamu alaikum to everybody. Say assalamu alaikum. Say no. Okay, get down. You're snagging my niqab. Get down. Okay. So, let me take a sip. I decided to do a grocery haul. Ready? Stop attacking my groceries. Okay, here's what I got at the grocery store. Ready? Oranges. That's it. This girl, look at this girl. This is mine, thank you very much. Why? And listen to her purring, listen to this girl. Stop it, this is mine. It's mine, not yours. Yeah, I tell you, having a cat is like having another child. I kid you not, it's like having another child. I said I would not have any more children, inshallah. But man, when I got a kitten, little did I know, it was another child. Another child. She gets in trouble just like any child. She gets in the mischief just like any child. So, I guess technically I have three children. Go figure. So, I am about to grade my daughter's math homework before she wakes up. I forgot to grade it yesterday morning for the previous day. So I'm grading that, and I'm grading yesterday's homework. On Facebook, my regular Facebook page, where family and friends follow me. Well, yeah, family and friends following. Not my vlogger page or blogger page, but my regular page. One of my family members on my mom's side just started to follow me, and I just sent her pictures of my daughter and of my son and of me without the veil, and I just told her, this is me when I'm at home, and when I'm outside, I'm covered. So I'm pretty sure she's seen my profile picture, because remember the birthday picture I took? I don't know if you guys remember, but it still is my favorite picture. It's like, it's so regal. So like, it's so like I should be in the desert in a tent and just sitting all regal like. Anyways, yeah, I don't have a lot of family that know me as being Muslim, because they're so hardcore Christian, like, you know, totally like in the worship of Jesus alayhi salam, kind of hardcore. So it makes me nervous when I see someone from the family ask to follow me, and I have to let my guard down just a little bit. I'm very protective of myself. I'm very, very protective. I don't just let anybody in. I don't know if you guys understand where I'm coming from or if you understand what I'm saying, but I've been hurt a lot, you know, in my life. So my guard and my wall is always, always up. Especially when it comes to family, especially when it comes to a deen that I cherish with all my heart that took me so many years to find. I have to guard myself because I don't want anyone, especially family, coming down on me because of the choice that I've made for myself, for my spiritual well-being and for my mental well-being, you know. So when family asks to follow me, I kind of like have to, you know, weigh in. Okay, are they gonna, you know, give me trouble? And because I don't want to deal with the drama of it. It's like you either take me as I am or don't mess with me. Not don't mess with me, but if you either take me as I am or you just leave me be. You know, don't ask to follow me if you're gonna be shoving stuff down my throat and trying to make me feel bad about my way of life. I don't even call Islam a religion, because if you technically think about it, it's not a religion. It's a way of life. It's a way of living. It's a way of living your life peacefully, always remembering Allah and always keeping yourself in check, you know? So I don't consider Islam a religion. I consider it a way of living, a way of life. So I don't want someone criticizing the way of life I chose, you know? So my guard is up. Like if someone wants to follow me, it's like I have to look and see, okay, are you gonna give me trouble? Are you going to, you know, I don't know. My guard is constantly up because I don't want to be hurt and I don't want to be upset or anything. I do leave Qur'an, you know, ayahs of the Qur'an. I do use reminders because it's my way of da'wah. And when I have my daughter in picture in hijab or me in niqab, it's my da'wah and how we're living our lives. Like yesterday I put up a post saying that I was proud of my daughter because she's been leading me in Salat al-Fajr every morning since my voice had become, you know, kind of difficult. Not kind of, it just is. I'm straining myself constantly because I want people to hear me. But like I said, if I don't strain, all you're gonna hear is this. This is all you're going to hear. And it sounds like a whisper, but it's not. But if I strain myself, like use my throat, you can hear me better, but it's more painful for me and tiring for me because I'm straining. But she leads me in the Fajr prayer. So I was saying how I was so proud of her, and family have read it and have liked or loved it. And that's my form of dawah, you know, just putting reminders of how God is and how He always will be, and the blessings that, you know, that we appreciate and things like that. I don't know, I feel like I'm rambling, but I don't know, maybe you guys may understand. Leave a comment and let me know if you understand what I'm saying, where I'm coming from. But yeah, alhamdulillah. So I did accept her. She's like my late mother's oldest, one of her older sisters. And so I accepted her friend request, and you know, alhamdulillah. She's my aunt. Duh. I just said that she was my mother's oldest sister. Of course she's my aunt. Assalamu alaikum, everybody. Good afternoon. It's several hours later. It's 1:54. I have been working, not a lot. I was just situating some of the yarn I'm going to be using for don't pay attention to that mess that you just saw. Okay, anyways, I was just working on situating the yarn I'm going to be using for the doll's hair, and I managed to get some done, alhamdulillah. Yeah, I didn't do too much today. I don't know why, I just didn't. I guess I'm just so excited, I don't know what to do with myself. But I just situated some of the arms and the legs. I found out for the legs, I only half did them. So there was like one side that wasn't sewn, or the feet that wasn't completely sewn. So I had to go back and finish that up. And I just situated a lot of stuff and got the stuffing out. I can't believe it. I'm going to be stuffing and assembling the dolls. Wow, subhanAllah. I wonder how many I can get done before 4:30, because that's the scheduled time I have that I'll be ending my day, inshallah. So not too much as in the way of, you know, productivity. I wasn't very productive. I just situated the yarn and turned a couple of arms and outside in and fixed the feet and just... that's pretty much it, yeah. Not a lot, but alhamdulillah, I even posted on social media a little bit on my Instagram for the business for Little Muslima Dolls Boutique, for Facebook, and Legacy Lab that I follow too. So alhamdulillah. So I'm gonna go ahead and get started and see how much I get done. Alhamdulillah. Assalamu alaikum, everybody. Good evening, sort of. It's 5:48. It's almost time for my daughter to start getting ready for Taekwondo. My son called and sent me a text. He was wondering if I was gonna be available, but I told him for like 30 minutes and then I have to go to Taekwondo. But I don't know what he's up to. I don't know if he was trying to come by and visit for a few minutes. I don't know. But, yes.
It overflowed.
Well, clean it.
I'm never using that for the thingy again.
She's making waffles and she's having problems with the waffle maker. But anyways, guys, I've had a pretty good day. I am so glad I decided to make my own tags. The way they turned out is like as if another company made them. So I'm so glad I made the decision. Inhaling my niqab. So I'm so glad I made the decision to make my own tags for the dolls. So I'll be using those. I wish I could show you guys, but I don't want to show you anything until, you know, I have the finished products in front of me. So, sorry guys, you're just gonna have to wait. You had a little bit of sneak peek here and a little sneak peek there, but yeah, you're gonna have to wait for the final products, inshallah. I'm so excited. But anyways, I need to get my daughter ready for Taekwondo so we can get out of here. It is raining and I actually want to get there early so that I have time to dry off my tires.
Step, not toes, instep.